St. Mary's virginity does not mean that we have to be passive in our spiritual life. For God did not force himself in St. Mary's womb, nor did she conceive him unwillingly, but played an active role. God asked her to accept the divine incarnation, was realized by the free grace of God, but she herself humbly accepted obedience. The Church calls St. Mary the mother of all the living, the mother of the new life, and the second Eve. Eve lost the meaning due to her name, mother of every living, for by her disobedience to God, she obtained only death for her children instead of life, and became the mother of the dead. Her daughter, St. Mary, took her place, for by her faith and obedience and humility, she became, through the Holy Spirit, the mother of life. She offered to Adam's children the tree of life to eat and thereby live forever. Just as Eve, while wife of Adam, was still a virgin and became by her disobedience the cause of her death and of the whole human race, so Mary too, espoused yet a virgin, became by her obedience the cause of salvation of both herself and the whole human race. The knot of Eve's disobedience was loosened by Mary's obedience. For what the Virgin Eve had bound in unbelief, the Virgin Mary loosened through faith. According to Saint Irenaeus, Saint Mary has a distinctive function in God's plan towards our salvation, for she offered her free consent to God, that is, her obedience, issued through her faith. He also calls her Eve's advocate. Whereas Eve had disobeyed God, Mary was persuaded to obey God, that the Virgin Mary might become the advocate of the Virgin Eve. Let us keep our obedience to our Lord and His commandments, remembering His mother's obedience to Him.